Hi guys, this video is the fourth in a video series that shows how to make the desktop 5-axis CNC machine. This time I would like to assemble the spindle unit. The spindle is one of the parts that I were particular about when making this machine. This is because it is very difficult to cut metal that is harder than aluminum without a tough and high torque spindle. Even if it possible to cut, the vibration will increase and the end mill will break soon. And noisy. Some people who are not familiar with metalworking may not know how important a spindle is. This is CNC machine for home use. This motor seems to be made with the idea of using it as a mill spindle, but it is poor for processing metals that are harder than aluminum. Install the collet shaft to this spindle, to install the end mill. This is one of the causes that reduce the accuracy and strength of the spindle. This is the spindle of my machine. I wanted to show how to assemble after disassembling all of this spindle, but I couldn't disassemble it. This is because the bearings are shrink fitted onto the spindle shaft. In shrink fitting, parts with an inner diameter smaller than the outer diameter of the shaft are heated and expanded to increase the inner diameter, and then assembled to the shaft. After that, when the temperature down, the inner diameter becomes smaller and the shaft is tightened. This method can be assembled with high accuracy and without rattling. The disadvantage is that it is difficult to disassemble. Angular bearings are bearings that are used by applying preload in the axial direction. In the case of the type in which two angular bearings are set, by using the V mark with matching, it is possible to apply preload both the axial direction and the radial direction without rattling. For who want to know more about shrink fitting and angular bearings, there is an explanation video link in the overview column. The length of the inner ring and outer ring determines the preload of the rear angular bearing. The end face of the spindle case is 20 microns shorter than the end face of the rear bearing, and apply preload to eliminate rattling. Since the home use machine is assembled with a collet shaft and a spindle, the runout is very big. When machining, the teeth of the end mill cut the material unevenly, quickly spoil the end mill. And it generates noise. Not only the strength and accuracy of the spindle. Also the strength of the entire machine is not enough to machine metal that is harder than aluminum. If I push the spindle with my finger, it move easily. This is my 5-axis machine. It is like this. At least this level of accuracy and strength is required to machine iron. Even if push the spindle of real industrial machines with my finger, it is never move. This is a 3-speed gear for turning the spindle. When I designed it, I wanted to be able to change gears with G-code. But, I gave up because it was too difficult. I have introduced this transmission in other videos. So please check them if you are interested. It also introduces noise issues and balancing. The links in the overview column. How was it? Did you enjoy it? If you watched this video until the end, I think you enjoyed this video. I recommend that you subscribe to the channel, so that you do not miss the next video. Also, if you are interested in the 5-axis CNC machine I made, I recommend to see the related video. Link in the overview column. Some part of the reference CAD data of this 5-axis machine is available for free on the website. There is a charge for the CAD data used in the previous and current videos. If you are just interested in this machine, you don't need to buy it. The video information will suffice. But if you really want to build your own machine, I think it's cheap. You can find out the detailed dimensions, range of motion, problems and improvements of this machine. And you will design a machine that is better than my machine. I also sell the CAD data used this time. If you want to make your own 5-axis CNC machine, this CAD data will help you plan. However, it is not advisable to make the complete copy. Because the machine is made by trial and error and is designed based on the machining methods I can do and the materials available. I recommend that you refer to this CAD data and modify the design based on your work environment. You will be able to make a better machine than the one I made. See you again.